Welcome to this session on deploying an application in OutSystems. In this session, we're going to discuss how to deploy an application and execute the deployment plan. We'll also look at the anatomy of a deployment and discuss all the different steps that occur during the deployment. So, deploying an application in Lifetime will take a tagged version of the application from one environment to another. When creating the deployment plan, we'll actually choose the version of the application that we're going to deploy, which will then grab its exact development state of when it was tagged and begin moving it to the next environment. To deploy the application, a user must have change and deploy permissions in the destination environment, not the source environment. Before we can actually deploy, we need to make sure that the deployment plan has been validated. So, Lifetime will perform an impact analysis to guarantee that the application in the plan is not going to break anything in the destination environment. So, we'll start with a validation button, and once we've done the validation, if it's successful, it will return a green button that will allow us to continue and deploy the application. Now, once the plan is defined, to be able to execute that plan in the destination environment, we need to go to that environment and find the Deploy Now button. Users that have the correct permissions to do the deployment will see this button, otherwise it will be grayed out. If the user has the capability of doing the deployment, they'll also be able to edit the plan, discard the plan, save it again or change its notes, and view the overall change log. Once the deployment is started, the deployment screen will begin showing the progress of that deployment operation. So we'll see the different steps that are supposed to occur during a deployment, and the deployment can be aborted up until the fifth step of the process. So as each step is executing and it succeeds, we'll see the check mark, we'll actually see a progress circle for anything that's being worked on, and the abort button will be available whenever we're still allowed to abort that particular deployment. Now, just because we're the person executing the deployment doesn't mean we're the only ones that can see that progress. So the deployment process can be followed by users once the execution has been started. So while the deployment is being executed, any IT user should be able to go in and see the progress of that deployment. Now, what is important is it's only possible to define and deploy a single plan between two different environments at one time. So what that means is if there's a plan that exists between development and quality assurance, then we would have to discard that plan or edit it. We couldn't create a second plan to actually be able to do deployments as well. Now, when the deployment is started, the first thing it does is retrieve the applications from version control. It then analyzes the impact on any running business processes, and then begins generating and compiling the optimized C# code. It will analyze the database and make sure to create any differential SQL scripts needed for the database side, and it will distribute the compiled applications to all the front-end servers that are going to need it. It will then update the database, hot deploy the new versions, and make sure everything inside of the environment is synchronized. So these are the various steps happening behind the scenes during a deployment. If we look at these in slightly different form, here we can see that in the source environment, we'll retrieve the modules from version control. We'll then send them to the deployment controller of the destination environment. It will do the analysis and decide whether or not the business processes will have any problems, and if not, it will begin to generate and compile the code. It will analyze the database and create those SQL scripts, and then it will begin distributing all of the compiled code to the different front ends that are going to need to deploy it. Once it's distributed that code, it will update the database, and then the deployments will occur in the front ends, so those applications will be available on their application servers. Once all of that's happened, Lifetime will be notified, and Lifetime will be able to synchronize the environments and know that the applications are available. So we've covered a lot about deploying applications in OutSystems. So that's it. Thanks for listening and have a great day.